In today's video, we're going to start to build an extensive tram network, an elevated tram network for that. We are also going to expand FlyVoxington, and we're also going to play some farms. Let's get building. Welcome back to City Skylines 2. I am excited for the second part where we dive into FlyVoxington further. First, I wanted to create some farms and I go to the specialized industry to create these animal farms. I think these look super amazing. I also placed down one of these rock farms, not really a farm, but these rock mining sites. Super cool. And I love this bit right here. You can go into the specialized industry district tool and adjust the district on the edge points. Super, super amazing. I also wanted to create a sort of a unique farm layout area design, because I just love the fact that you can be so precise with this district tool, and it just looks cool as if though you've curved the district area. Super, super amazing. I think this turned out really, really cool. Expanding the city further with some arterial roads. I just love the road tool. You can just simply draw through another road and it will create the intersection for you. This is epic. I love playing around with the road tools. Super epic, let's go. You can also turn off the pedestrian crossing simply by right-clicking when the pedestrian crossing option is selected. I love this feature. It's basically TMPE mod in a light version. You can also tell the AI not to take right or left turns, which I also do here. I don't want the AI to go right there. They should use the slip lane and the left turns, of course, as well. We see that right here. Take the left turn, no left turns on that road, and the same with here. I think that's so great to controlling your traffic. Super amazing. And look at that, the road tools are so much fun to me. They're like my top feature for sure. I love the road tools. Going with a basic road layout, then I realized I've reached the milestone. Yes, indeed, Grand Village. And look at that, district creation tool, loan limit, production panel, policies. Super amazing stuff that we've unlocked here. Low rent housing, low density offices, the grain farming, forestry, public transport, parks and recreation. Super amazing stuff. We will see more public transport later. I unlock the trams here just because I have something planned for that. And continuing with the road layout. Of course, in City Skylines 2, you also want to create walkability in your city to get the residents off of your roads. Create a small pedestrian crossing simply by dragging the pedestrian path to a road and then over a road to get that crossing. And then I got this message. I saw this message from Chirper here, feeling sick about the water. And then I realized, oh Lord, I placed the rock quarry next to the groundwater depot. So I had to kind of switch that over because the water, I guess, was getting polluted. And so I just created this basic layout right here. I just thought it was kind of funny that I actually used the Chirper messages. to find that problem. And we talked about that in the Dev Diary videos. That is such a cool feature that you can actually see if there's something wrong in your city just by finding the chirper messages. So amazing. That helped me a lot. This is a cool thing. You see how the zoning squares are on the main arterial road, but I want them on the smaller road? Well, as we already know, the zoning squares will prioritize the first road you draw. So what I simply do here is take out the first road again, redraw it. So now the skinnier road is basically the first road, and you can see the zoning squares are just the way I want them. Of course, since we unlocked parks and recreation, we need to place a park, and this one looks really cool. This is the fire site, campfire site. It looks amazing. I think it looks really, really good. And with so few detailing options in the game, you really have to get creative. But I think placing bushes is gonna be like my new favorite thing to do in terms of detailing. Looking really good. Road tools can get finicky sometimes, as you've just seen. This is, you gotta fiddle around with it to get it just the way you want it. But in the end, I think it works pretty good if you're just patient enough. Love the roundabout builder as well. Going with some pedestrian roads in between just to mix it up, and again, pedestrian pathways make it easy for your citizens to get across town. Now we place the trams, the tram network. I realized there that where I wanted to place it, I didn't leave enough space. So of course you gotta take some stuff out. Never be afraid to change your layouts around, not a big problem. Created this space and the tram depot fits in here nicely actually. I had it backwards that the first time I placed it, but then I realized that I'm like, oh, I can flip that around and look at that. The building itself is really cool. And then I figured, okay, let's do something really cool here. And let's actually get an elevated tram line, but not just an elevated tram line. We're gonna create a pedestrian road on top of the existing road because we can with the cut and fill tool. Let's go. All you do is raise it to a certain height and then you can draw over the roads. And what I do then is simply go to the public transport tab, select the tram tracks, and simply upgrade the pedestrian road to also have tram tracks. Select the replace tool, and look at that. We have the pedestrian road, and it now has tram tracks on top. Let's go. I wasn't really sure about the design of the end point of the tram. We don't really need a loop because the trams can simply turn around and drive, like they can just drive backwards, not turn around, but they can just drive backwards, which I think is really, really amazing. I ended up being a bit too close to the road here, which I noticed later when I wanted to place a stop there. So I changed that around again, but this is really, really cool. You can have the tram stops there and the tram will just simply drive backwards then. And I think that's such a cool feature. On to connecting the tram now. And we unlock another milestone, the tiny town. Let's go. More loan limit, mixed housing, we got shopping and residential, mixed use, super amazing. Vegetable farming, communications is a big one. We definitely have to place internet and some more policies, which is really, really cool. So as I said, the road tools can be a bit finicky, but be patient. That's a tip I can give you for sure. Be patient with them and they will cooperate to your liking and your city will be, the layout will be so beautiful, 100%. I mean, look at that. It's like so smooth, so smooth. And then you simply place the tram stops. I did that here on both sides, one on each side. Just place the tram stops in a bit of a distance to each other as you would do in City Skylines 1. I place one down here as well. Then we go to the tram line tool and simply connect the stops. Easy peasy. Connect the last stop and then you go back to the first one, complete the line. You don't have to drive a loop. I did that with both sides, and look at that, here we go. The trams are going through. Obviously, we need to connect some pedestrian paths up here because the pedestrians need to be able to get up to the tram stops. And I did that on every tram stop. I've created the pedestrian walking path, and I think it's really, really amazing. It was fun. That was the last one. And it started snowing actually in the city. Look at that beautiful view. I love this. Looks so amazing. It's kind of difficult to build in the snow, but I loved it. I loved it so much. And there we go. You can go into the tram menu, of course, because I realized, oh, we have a lot of vehicles for such a short route. And you can simply switch the model. You can see all the information. I have to lower the ticket prices because, I mean, come on. I wanted to go free, but then I was like, ah, $2 is fine. $2 is fine. And we lower that to, I think, 4 vehicles. Yeah, 4 vehicles on both lines. Easy as pie. So simply click on the public transport and then the menu will pop up. Click on the form you want to adjust and then simply click on the line that you want to go in. And here also the ticket price and the number of vehicles is going to be lowered. And of course, now we're going into the communications because we want to provide internet for our residents. So what I do here, nothing fancy, just a basic road and then drop an antenna. And I do that on this side as well. So we have good coverage. Upgrade with enhancing the signal, the Wi-Fi signal, because why not? We want to create good internet for our residents of Flyvoxington. Then I realized, holy heck, I haven't even bought any tiles in quite some time. I was wondering which tiles should I also buy, and I was like, oh, I got 4 left, so maybe these 4, I wasn't really sure. You can deselect the tiles, by the way, by right-clicking, and I decided to buy these 4, so we got the island complete for the future expansion. And there you can see, you just saw it briefly there, the visuals when it snows, it's very bright. I love that we can upgrade the bridges, easy peasy, so amazing. So the visual is very, very bright, but it's okay, actually. It's not too bad. I think it's fine. And just this map, it takes some months to snow. I think it snows from October to March or something, and we're in November. Here's another good tip, to get rid of the wastewater. I simply upgraded the development tree of the water to unlock the water treatment, and then just simply upgraded with everything it got. Super interesting. Once it's upgraded, you can move the entire building with the upgrade. That's so amazing. And that will purify our wastewater, and that way we can turn off or even just delete the sewage outlet. So amazing. I also decided to create a small forestry industry as well. And I did a basic interchange. And again, this is so much fun with the road tools. Like, look at how easy it is. Upgrade to have a dedicated lane for your lane mathematics. Super amazing. Look at how smooth this is. This was so much fun to build. I'll just leave you with it. I am not really good with building interchanges. I've mentioned it a bunch of times before, but this is so amazing. I don't want to say it's like super, super easy, but the road tools help a lot. And look at that. It's a perfectly functioning interchange. It looks really good. And then I just create like the most basic layout for a forestry industry. I use the dirt road and place the forestry. Same principle. You place the main building and then you create the district basically around it. Again, you can micro adjust the dots. Super, super fun. I created 4 of these little parcels here of the forestry industry. So there we go. There we have it. That was the episode, the second part of the Cities Skylines 2 gameplay. I do hope you enjoyed this. And if you want to talk about this video or Cities Skylines in general, I highly recommend the City of Friends Discord. It's a joint Discord I run with 5 other amazing builders. It is linked in the description below, of course. I'm there on a regular basis. We love to hang out and chat about Cities Skylines in particular, but mostly anything. And also, I have recently launched the YouTube channel membership. So if you're interested in more content, maybe some secret content only for YouTube members, there are a bunch of videos on there just for the members. Feel free to check that out as well. Otherwise, thank you all so much for watching. Have a great rest of your day, and please stay safe out there. Bye.